One of the things I think is really unique and special about Psychonauts is the figments. I love the figments because we have so many great comic artists working at Double Fine, and it gives a chance to just show their 2D art. They're about navigation, but they're also about storytelling. They help tell the story of what the kind of half-formed thoughts are in someone's mind, and they make the world look dreamy. And they're back in Psychonauts 2, and I think they look a lot better, and they're even more figmenty. Figmenty fresh.
Sometimes you'll hear some crying, and that's an emotional baggage piece. You need to find the luggage tag that goes with it to make it happy again.
I think it's a moment of happiness where you're alleviating their loneliness. I think that's really how I saw it. You see that little animation, and they're just so pleased to be together. It's sweet, you know? Also, the not hearing the crying is great.
But then we have nuggets of wisdom, which just one nugget of wisdom equals one intern rank. So they're pretty valuable. You'll find them at the ends of more difficult paths or secret areas. And each one looks a little bit different in each brain.
So the half a mind is definitely my favorite collectible. It's a little half of a brain sitting there dancing around. When you've picked up two of them, they splat together and gives you extra health.
And the more half of minds you collect, the more brains you have for combat or boss fights, for example. So the half of minds are a really powerful collectible, and they're worth hunting down.
So in the physical world, we have the classic Psy Challenge marker, which is comprised of Psy Challenge cards and Psy Challenge cores, both of which you can find and or buy.
You can pay to combine them together with a Psy core and raise your character rank.
In addition to that, we have these supply chests that are scattered around the HQ that the spies store valuable supplies in, usually Citanium. But those are locked, so Raz has to go and steal. So Raz has to find the keys that are scattered around the HQ in the physical world. Trying not to make Raz sound like a miscreant or whatever.
If you play the first Psychonauts, you might remember that vaults are kind of more locked away memories. They're things that these characters don't necessarily want to think about, right? As Raz approaches the vault, it tries to run away, and once Raz actually grabs a hold of it, you'll learn something interesting about that character through a series of these really beautifully illustrated 2D images in our vault viewer.
You can sort of like just take it in at your own pace. And on top of that, they're all Scott C. drawings, so they're fantastic.
That give you a little bit more story about what's happening in each brain. So, for example, in Hollis's brain, you get a little bit more backstory about what happened to her in medical school and why you're in a casino hospital in the first place. So the vaults are very, very important if you're very interested in who the characters are and why they do what they do.
All right, I'll be right back.